Arabesque on a Sketch by Michelangelo by Jens Peter Jacobsen. Did the wave make land, taking land and seeping slowly, rattling with the pearls of gravel back into the world of waves? No, it reared up like a charger, raising high its dripping counter. Through its mane the spray was sparkling snow-white as the back of swans. Sunbeam spray and mist of rainbows quivered upward through the air. Shape it cast off, shape it shifted, flew on outspread wings of swans through the lustrous light of sunshine. I know your flight, you flying breaker, yet the golden day will founder, will, wrapped in dusky night-time mantle, lie down, tired to rest. And in his breath the dew will glitter, blossoms will close about his couch before you reach your goal. And when you reach the golden grating, skimming on outstretched wings in silence, on over ample paths of the garden, on over waves of laurel and myrtle, over the crown of dark magnolia, watched by its bright and calmly blinking, watched by its staring blossom eyes, down over secretly whispering iris, born and lulled into tear-gentle dreaming, by the geranium scent, by tuberose and jasmine's heavy-breathing scent, carried toward the white-walled villa, with its moonlit window-panes, with its tall and somber sentry, set by tall and tranquil cypresses. Then you will perish in fearful foreboding, burn yourself up with tremulous longing, gliding forth like a breeze from the ocean. You will die among leaves from the vine, rustling leaves from the vine, on the balcony's marble threshold, while the chilly silk of the balcony curtain slowly undulates in heavy folds. And the grapes in golden clusters from the anxiously twisted tendrils downward drop to the garden grass. Glowing night, slowly you burn across the earth. The strangely changeable smoke of dreams flutters and swirls away in your wake. Glowing night. Wills are but wax in your supple hand, fidelity but reeds at a puff of your breath. And what is wisdom leaned up to your bosom, and innocence inveigled by your gaze, that nothing sees, but wildly sucks a deluge of the red tide of veins, as the moon sucks up the ocean's icy waters. Glowing night, blind, enormous maenad, out of the gloom comes gleaming and burbling uncanny waves of uncanny sound, clinking of goblets, sudden singing clang of steel, dripping of blood, and the bleeding gurgling and thick-voiced madness bellowing blended with crimson desire's strident scream. But, glowing night, the sigh, sigh that will swell and die, die to be born anew, you, glowing night, the sigh. Lo, the curtain's silken waves are parted, and a woman, tall and splendid, dark in outline in the darksome air, sacred grief in your gaze, grief that knows no succor, hopeless grief, searing, doubting grief. Nights and days were over the earth, seasons changing like cheeks' complexion, generations in long dark wave upon wave, roll across the earth, roll and pass away. Meanwhile time is slowly dying. Why then life? Why then death? Why then live when we still must die? Why then fight when we know the sword must be wrested from our hand some day? Why then all these pyres of pain and torment, untold hours of life of slowly suffering, slowly ebbing out in deathbed suffering? Is this your thought, majestic woman? Calm and quiet she stands upon the balcony, has no word, no sigh, no lamentation. Dark in outline in the darksome air, like a sword plunged through the heart of night.